January 30th, 2011. We met at a Junior Hadassah dance at the Essex House.
At the Essex House.
In Newark, New Jersey. When the world is cold.
No, it was not love at first sight. Although I thought she was pretty and redhead, and I was taken by her, and I asked her to dance. And after that, I asked if she'd like to go home, escort her home. A friend of mine was driving my brother's new Buick convertible, and he had picked up a young lady too, so we went to Millman's. Millman's is in downtown, is a hot dog joint, and they served foot-long hot dogs, and they had in the back a place to park. And it was a necking ground. You bought the girl a hot dog and she was supposed to neck it.
And I said to him, you bought me a hot dog and now you want to squeeze it out of me? Take me home. And then he took me home, called me on the phone. And he wanted to go out on a date. Told him, I go out on a date, I don't like to wear my armor. And he said, I promise you I'll behave myself. And he did.
Perfect gentleman.
He used to date me only on Wednesdays. And I told my friends, he only dates me on Wednesday. I wonder if he's married or he has a girlfriend, another girlfriend. I'm going to get dressed up this time. And then the next, that day, he asked me to go out on Saturday.
I had many girlfriends.
Slowly.
But I guess I was taken by her. I asked her out one evening, and what was the story? And I said, I love you. And she says, I'm glad you asked me to marry you. This is all Amos. Which means...
this is the truth. Won't you please arrange it? I guess about a year.
Less than a year. But that's okay. Who worried about time?
My mother was a man's barber. My father was a newspaper writer for the Tug and the Forwards. And he went for a haircut. I think he was like more like his mother. My father-in-law could sit and listen to the opera. He was a quieter man. He didn't say too much, but my mother-in-law had a lot to say.
Oh, so that's why he's like his mother.
That's right. I guess I was like my mother. She was I thought she was a fairly strong lady, but my father was very strict. He ran a business, but my mother did most of the work.
She missed a lot about her father.
Wow.
Well, because her father was a newspaper reporter. He lived in Manhattan. You want to tell us?
He broke a gangster group, and the police told him he had to get out of New York City. They're looking to kill him. So he had a horse and a buggy, and he went to Long Island. And then they told him that maybe he should move out of New York area altogether, and he went to Perrineville. When he went to Perrineville, he heard there was a hotel for sale on Railroad Avenue. He bought that place. We catered to the migrant laborers that came up from the South to pick potatoes. And they worked hard. We all worked hard.
I was based at an air base called Horsham St. Faith. I was on a crash crew. Crash crew, the fire department or whatever you call it. If planes came in and they had bombs on them or they were on fire, and we go out. Most of the outfit that I was with were training to go to Japan. But I was sent to Galveston, Texas. Went swimming every day. Didn't do any work on the base. But because the firemen there were civilians, and they said they'd rather I didn't do any work, otherwise they would be out of a job. I had
He played around with the women.
A couple of years after that, we were in Houston, Texas, at a Super Bowl. Drove down to Galveston, and we went shopping in every store that we went into. Shirley would ask the clerks there, take a look at my husband. Do you know anybody around here that looks like him with a boat, a big nose? Any
children?
Any of his children around?
Well, your father wanted to have a lot of kids. I tried to have a child and I couldn't. That just didn't happen. I went to see a doctor and he says, well, I think you're pregnant. And I was. I was always pregnant. I always admired my sister because my sister had a large family and she had a very tight family and I spent a lot of time there. I even remember plucking chickens in her house. You know, we used to get the chickens killed by a shecha, and then we would bring them home, and we would
pluck them,
take the feathers out of them. None of you ever did that, right?
No.
I had the four children. Seymour had said he would like to have another child to name after his father. I said, well, I'll think about it. Because I wasn't sure whether I would have any more children after. That's why it took so long. Before I had time to think, I was pregnant. And I remember going to Dr. Siegel. I was telling him I was pregnant again, and he says, that's wonderful. And he mentioned a name in town who has a lot of children because I said, I only hope we can afford all these children to send them to school, to clothe them, and what have you. He says, each child brings your own mazel. And that's exactly what happened. Then we had Shari Beth. And at my age, I was turning 40, that's kind of I thought was a special gift. And I think it was a special gift to all my children.
We'll speak for ourselves, Mom.
I had an assistant.
Mother.
Susan was the assistant mom.
Was I the assistant mom or were you the assistant mom?
Yes. The whole area of girls were in my house constantly. And one day I called up Dad and I said, you know, I have to get out of here. There's too many kids here, too much shopping to do. And that day he came home, we packed up our station wagon, we went out down the shore, and we stayed there just about 10 years, I think.
They went down every summer.
Oh. I didn't decide to name him Manassas. It just so happened. I had a brother named Saul. Okay. Stuart is named after Seymour's grandfather.
Shepsel of Rome.
All right, and so does that translate into Stuart, or you just pick Stuart out of the hat?
Well, that was one of the names in fashion.
Stanley, that was named after my mother's brother. Everyone was named after a relative that had this first initial S.
Shirley, I think you were in your last year in high school. My mother had passed away, and she was kind of down, and I asked her if she'd like to come and spend and do some bookkeeping for me. All of a sudden, she started telling me what to do. So I said to her, look, I have a business that's rather...
successful.
It's rather successful, and all of a sudden you come in and you want to run it for me. So back off.
Did you use those words?
Yes!
They knocked on our door. They had Christmas trees. The day after Christmas, who wants to buy a Christmas tree? And they were trying to sell Christmas trees. They were interested, they would fool around with them. And then they tell them, you're on candid camera. It was fun.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Well, I had a partner. And we had a store up on Dyckman Street. One day this tall kid, black kid, came in and asked for a job. And my partner said to him, well, like, how old are you? And he said, 14. And Bob said to him, I think you're too young to work. He said, what do you mean too young? You see that kid back there that's working for you? He's the same age as I am, as a little boy. And how come you hired him? He says, well, I'm sorry, I can't hire you. And that was the end of Loyal Cinders. And he went on to bigger and better things.
We would have dinner on Shabbos, and everybody could not go out on Shabbos because that was the day that we were all sitting down for dinner. And each child had a job to do. After dinner, we would go out of the kitchen, go into the den, and each child took turns cleaning off the table or the doing the dishwasher, whatever they had to do. And now when I go to Shari Beth's house, I see her boys doing exactly what she was taught.
Shari Beth was always your favorite.
I was the middle of the
always. Oh, Shari Beth can't do no wrong.
I got plenty of letters saying, I'm running away from home.
Mm. Okay.
Do you remember that?
Laugh a lot. Keep going. You do have spads. You do have other things, sicknesses and things that come on. But if you laugh a lot, I think things will go smoothly.
Communication was very important. We used to get up before the kids got up, sit and talk if something was going on and what we should do.
So communication and laughter, that's the key?
That's the key.
It's been a good life. Shirley got a little sick, she's going to get out of that. I have some problems. We manage that. And we're going to go on with our lives, hopefully for many years, and be well.
L'chaim!
Azai Gazan.
Good afternoon.
For me, but to love you, and the way you look tonight. With each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fear apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose, touches my foolish heart. Lovely. Never, never change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way.